Hey, turn around. I'm here. Okay. Hello, folks. My name is Eugen Oprina, and I'll be your host. Thanks to Looking China Project from Beijing Normal University, I have finally arrived in Qinghai, in a place where I expected to see tradition and some signs of modernity. We are in Xining, the capital of Qinghai province, the one close to Tibet. We'll rush together to the railway station. On the way, we will see some bits of this old traditional Chinese city. In order to enjoy this 360 experience, please pay attention to the following convention. Whenever you see this sign on the screen, turn around and look, okay? You are free to look everywhere all the time, but to be sure that you're not losing the action, when you see this sign, turn around. Look. What is it here?
这里是昆仑桥，就是青海省的一个跨河的一座大桥。然后我们的前边呢可以看到很多的高楼，然后这边就是青海省老区，就是新城开发之前的一个城市中心。这里汇聚了商业、政治以及一部分的功能住宅。
What do you think about it, folks?
这里呢是万达集团在青海省落地的第一个万达广场，也是中国海拔最高的万达广场。有这里汇聚了大量的时尚主题餐厅、地方特色餐厅、国内知名餐厅，还有大型的连锁餐饮、甜品小吃。可以说呢，这里是所有美食的一个聚集地，也是一个人们购物消费的一个时尚中心。大家可以顺着我手的方向看，在我的右手边这座寺庙呢，是位于青海省的一个区，位于青海省城东区的南禅寺，它是青海省最大的汉传佛教比丘尼寺，也称为法幢寺。
Wonderful。
我们可以看到，现在可以听到，里面有很多诵经的声音。然后在这个季节呢，也有很多外地的游客会到这边去参观朝拜。
普通话得懂啊？
我后期会翻译成英文给他。
Slowly, slowly, traveling through this huge city situated at 2,300 meters altitude, we approach the railway station. We are here.Because today they have opened a new high-speed route from Xining to Xi'an. We will be traveling together, and as the title of our program said, we will have a train talk. This way, you'll listen to interesting stories while gazing to the window, viewing this beautiful part of China from the back of a white horse who's running with 250 kilometers per hour. So, it's not the destination we are aiming for, it's the journey.
你们先把名字写上，因为这个也是数量有限。
今天你们就好好把这个书看看就差不多。
你先看啊。
喂。哦，我这会儿正热背着呢。对。明天下午6点 OK 啊？
他真是。
那些菜都非常好。我看了看了，特别好。
This is Liu Shuang. She is 28. She is the chief of train on our route to Xi'an. This is her dormitory inside the railway station. Here she is living together with her colleagues. If in the past Confucian teachings fostered a patriarchal society,where the female role was procreation and perpetuating the family line, in communist China, gender equality was emphasized and Mao's slogan "Women hold half of the sky" became extremely popular. So, our chief of train is a modern Chinese woman. She was born in Jiangsu province and has a major in environmental engineering from Bioengineering Institute in Wuhan. I wondered why did she picked up the railway industry?
这个主要是跟我的家族有关系，因为我的父辈或者说我的祖父辈那一层，他们就随着当时中国的西部发展，西部大开发啊，随着铁路来到了这边，来到这边之后就一直在铁路这样的单位里面工作，在铁路没改革之前一直属于铁道部管。后面呢，然后我父辈就是我爸妈也是都是在铁路正常上班，然后他们认识也是在铁路认识，然后后来走到一起。所以有我了之后，我本来上完大学的之后，我其实之前也是想留在内地发展，因为总觉得自己的家乡待了很多年，就业压力非常大，在外面去做自己的事情的时候，工作也会很难，生存也会很难。再加上我爸我妈就一直觉得我应该传承他们的这些东西。那像我现在走到高铁已经有快3年的时间了，就很明显的感受到，首先你在高铁上你的职责是非常重要的，你的要比普速车的职责还要去重，你要去强化自己自身的责任感和使命感。我其实是很开心，但同时更多的应该是自豪感，就是你在一个很年轻的年龄你可以走到这个岗位，然后得到大家的认可。
你觉得从西宁咱们这条线到西安这条线有什么特别的地方吗？
特别的我觉得就是主要是有很多的景点。
Through the train window, we can see many impressive sceneries. What we see now is a village. It is very different from the old rural countryside, and it shows us how a traditional landscape became a modern industrial area. If you turn around looking to Liu Shuang, we'll do a 360 magic trick which will allow us to see over both sides of the train in the same time. Here we see an interesting formation of capacious mountains. And to get a glimpse of old China, we can admire the Chinese agriculture system called Family Production Responsibility System, as well as a beautiful temple.
Like 高原旅行的时候，我们配有很多高原的一些食用的药。一些血压计、血氧仪啊，这些你在内地车上都是看不到的，因为高原旅行有些人会有一些就是高原反应，然后速效救心丸呀，一些红景天这类，对，红景天
去那个高反
啊，专门是这就是针对高原旅行的，像走拉萨那边车，我们还会车上有氧气瓶，纯氧的氧气瓶，就是为了在车上一旦有这种紧急需要供氧的旅客提供纯氧。对。
那这条线路开通之后，给旅客啊。给整个城市的连接，它的意义应该是很大的，
意义非常大，我觉得，因为在就是青海省跟就是甘肃省，包括西藏整个区域来说，它其实相对于整个大的中国来说，它是一个比较封闭的地方了，因为中间一直都是由普速列车去贯穿，那现在动车开通了之后，大大压缩了旅客的出行时间，就我们将近能缩小一半的时间就到达目的地了，那为旅客出行提供了非常便利的一个交通工具。
您在铁路上工作了这么多时间，这么长时间，有一些什么感动的小故事吗？能说一到两个吗？
再就是像在去年，应该是2015年过年那一天，我是突然在家干活的时候，因为过年的时候会有家里很多活要干，不小心把腰扭了，因为春节那天你没有办法去安排人家在春节当天去替你，我就坚持走了，因为我们公司的传统就是在列车上春节当天需要给旅客演一台列车小春晚。所以上车之后，除了服务旅客，我还要去让大家去排节目、演出、彩排。回来之后，我到医院去一拍片子，结果发现是骨折，就是腰部的一块骨头脱落了。后来在家就一直住院养护。就我们工作当中会有很多这样的事情，自己能把自己吓到。那后面你走车的时候，神经绷紧的时候，你其实是没有什么感觉的。
After 10 hours in the train, we have arrived back to Xining.Liu Shuang is finishing her duty as a chief of train, gathers her stuff, and heads back to her dormitory in the train station. But the day is not over. She has reserved a table in the private restaurant, and she's heading to meet her friends. She's single and enjoys life in this position for now. Later, she may settle down with the right man, marry and make a family. However, she plans to open her own business or work as a freelancer. This way, she says, she will enjoy her own freedom. Her homeland in Jiangsu left deep traces in her soul. She was born by the sea, and she still goes to swim every week. She eats mainly fish, and her favorite movie is Pirates of the Caribbean. To complete a day, most evening, Liu Sheng meets Liu Xingkai, a local celebrity, music producer, and guitar teacher. She likes folk music and decided to learn how to play it. In this experience, we have grasped some beautiful sights of Western China, and we have met Liu Sheng, a genuine girl who is true with her feelings, true with her emotions, true to her will to become a better person, true with her heritage, with her family tradition, and last but not least, true with the unbreakable bond with her birthplace.